to talk about the joint base at Fort Dix McGuire-Lakehurst, because if you remember a couple weeks ago, we were joined by a friend of the show, Congressman Tom MacArthur, who represents the Southern Jersey district. And you know, he was talking about the military appropriations bill. He was talking about the fact that the president was pushing back on this effort to fund the base. And we're now joined by Mac Thornberry. Mac Thornberry is a congressman from Texas, and he happens to be the chairman of the Armed Services Committee in the House of Representatives. Congressman Thornberry, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Good morning. Glad to be here.
So let me ask you, Congressman, you are headed to New Jersey this week. And if you could just tell me why you're coming, why is this base important, important enough, at least for you and Congressman MacArthur to be here to talk about it?
Well, I'm coming because Tom asked me, and he can be pretty darn persistent. he has been talking to me about the unique features of Joint Base McGuire-Dix-Lakehurst, and because I think it's the only base in the country with three services participating. And he and I have traveled, for example, in Eastern Europe together, where he's talked to me about the contributions of that area to national security, but he wanted me to come see it. I'm going
to
come
see it. So, Congressman, of course, we're happy to welcome you to New Jersey. There's some things you're going to have to do when you're here. You're going to need to get a pork roll and egg sandwich. Because nothing says Jersey than that. So that, you know, I'm just going to, we're going to throw out these.
He left this part out of the invitation.
Did he leave that out? Okay, don't worry. We got you covered. Let me ask you, on a serious note, how contentious is it in Washington with the president of the United States looking to veto bills like this and pushing back? Do you think, is this just politics? And are they, is the White House playing politics with our national security? And is this base potentially caught in the crosshairs of a misguided political agenda?
Short answer, yes. And as a matter of fact, it's unprecedented, because what the president did a few weeks ago was to veto a defense bill, not because of anything that was in it, but to try to use it as leverage to force Congress to pass other things that he wanted to. And everybody from Wall Street Journal, Washington Post wrote that it was historic in a bad way. Now, there's been some water under the bridge since then. The president finally signed the exact same bill with some small funding adjustments. But the point is, he was willing to put national security out there as a political football, and that's just never happened from a commander-in-chief before, and it sure never happened with the sort of dangerous world that that we have. And so that puts more pressure on us at Congress, to tell you the truth, to try to do the right thing for the country. As I mentioned, this world is dangerous and getting more dangerous, and we need those vital facilities and the people who work there, the people who serve in the military, to help keep us safe.
Right. Now, let me ask you, Congressman, the president made a very big deal about the Paris climate change conference. And if you listen to just that side of the political aisle, you're going to hear that climate change is our biggest problem. What reaction does that get from members of Congress like you that are fighting not only for jobs in the military, and we know that veterans unemployment is very high, so that's another side issue. Terrorism is at the front of mind for everyone as we try to keep ourselves safe. What does that say to you, and how do you combat that? When you've got a president that is saying, you know, let's push ISIS off the front page and let's talk about climate change.
Well, it's very discouraging. And so the way we combat it is to try to keep bringing the topic back to what I believe is the first job of the federal government, and that is to defend the country. It's certainly the first responsibility of a commander in chief. Especially with everything swirling around us. So as a matter of fact, we had a hearing yesterday in our committee with the Secretary of Defense, the Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, and somebody asked them that question: what's more important, terrorism or climate change? And, you know, after a little fudging that everything's important, et cetera, they both acknowledge that terrorism is at the forefront of their concerns right now.
Yeah.
So, and that's what we on Armed Services Committee, Tom included, try to keep our eye on the ball. What is the what are the threats to the country, and what can we in Congress do to help meet those threats, especially with a president who seems to have a different agenda?
Yeah. All right, Congressman, real quick, how is Tom MacArthur doing? You know, give him a rating. He's been in there a year. How's he faring?
He is doing a great job. As a matter of fact, I appointed him the vice chairman of our military personnel subcommittee. As we go through these issues of pay and especially health care, Tom's private sector experience in the insurance business has been invaluable in trying to sort through how we can better provide for the men and women who serve our nation. As I mentioned, I've traveled with him in Eastern Europe. We are very glad to have him, and I hope y'all keep sending him back, because we're going to continue to use and abuse him at every opportunity.
All right, Congressman Mac Thornberry. Remember, Congressman, it's a pork roll, egg, and cheese. Have Tom buy it for you when you're on your way to the base on Friday morning. Thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Good talking to you.
You too, Bill.